Sticking Together, written by James Raynes and illustrated by Mitzi McKenzie-King. Brought to you by We Are Union. Animals can teach us something grown-ups need to know. At work, at home, at school, at play, wherever you may go. It doesn't matter if you're clothed in skin or fur or feather. Everyone is better off when we all stick together. When baby elephant stuck in mud needs help before it's sunk, the others come and pull it out by grabbing on its trunk. They stick together as a herd because the herd is stronger and keep their babies safe at least until their legs grow longer.
That was a bit of an adventure, wasn't it?
Cold enough for you, mate?
I'm freezing my feathers off.
Emperor penguins snuggle when it's freezing in the snow. Some stand outside and brave the cold, while others have a go at standing in the middle and keeping nice and warm. When penguins stick together, they can weather any storm.
Come on, birds.
All right. Everything's pretty quiet here. Thanks, mate.
Yum.
Oh, tummy tea.
My favourite.
Yum.
Vampire bats sound scary, but if you're feeling brave, I'll let you know what happens when they fly back to their cave.
I'm hungry.
Full bats look for hungry ones and share the food they found. They stick together to make sure each furry tummy's round.
Wrap your furry little lips around that.
Oh, a refill of the old creamy soda would be nice.
I beg your pardon.
Ow, my head!
When an injured dolphin needs to get up to the surface, it asks its friends to gather round. They're glad to be of service.
Go up.
Alright, I'll try.
You can do it.
Sticking together, dolphins show their friends they really care. They help it out, you lift it up, and let it get some air. Meerkats show how brave they are when snakes give them a fright. Side by side, they stand their ground instead of taking flight.
Stay tight, brothers.
Go on, get.
They stop the snake from swallowing a sister or a brother. By sticking close together, they look out for one another.
Don't bother.
Keep walking. Snake's got no legs.
All right, I'll leave. I'm leaving.
Go on, get.
I'm leaving.
When groups of swans fly far away, a V shape is the best. If the front swan's getting sleepy, it moves back for a rest.
You're looking like you're tiring a bit there. Don't worry, mate.
Another swan takes up the lead and gives the team assistance.
Stop, revive, survive.
They stick together and take turns to cover greater distance.
Are we there yet? You drive now, I'm tired.
Here you go, mate. My turn, you have a spell.
Oh, nice wingspan there.
Paw in paw, each otter holds onto another otter. So when they fall asleep, nobody drifts off in the water.
Good night, Eric.
Night, night.
Good night, Jimbo.
Good night.
Roger, have you brushed your teeth?
You off?
Yeah,
I'm off.
Did you use toothpaste?
Good night, Mavis.
Oh, where's my good blankie?
Did you use toothpaste?
Put me little sleeping cap on, I'm off to bed.
No, you need to use toothpaste.
Hold on tight, don't float off.
Good night there, Doris. Hold me hand.
They stick together in a raft, and though it's tightly spaced, when they wake up from their nap, no otter's been misplaced.
Oh, is that a warm current or has someone wet the bed?
They don't live in the wild, and you won't see them at the zoo, but my family sticks together, helping other people too. At work they join the union, so their workmates have more power. And we all know union members get paid much more by the hour. Yes, we're a union family. We know that teamwork's good, not just at work, but at my school and in our neighbourhood.
G'day, mate. How you going, comrade?
We look out for those around us, give them roses, share our bread, from the moment that we wake up until it's time for bed.
Mum, read the page about the elephant again for me. That's my favourite.